Guaranteed, isn't it? Well, I went back to nursing after being a Member of Parliament because I always wanted to finish my career doing the job I loved so very much. I started my nurse training at the age of 18, so it was amazing to finish and go to Parliament and then go back to nursing. It's
Oh.
just the most fantastic way of being part of the human race and helping people. It's a privilege to care for people who are sick or injured or just need the help of a nurse for a short time. And it's the most wonderful career that I would recommend to anyone. They're actually very similar as jobs. People come to you with some difficulties and they're upset or they're angry, and you learn, particularly as a nurse, how to deal with people, how to help, how to be empathetic. And I actually found the job of being a nurse so helpful when I was a Member of Parliament. I could really understand why people's lives become difficult because your health, physical health, is often influenced by mental health. And that's why it's so important to make sure that women have every opportunity in this world to keep well and to fulfill their potential. I know that point absolutely when I decided that I needed to get involved in politics. I always had a political view, and I really hope that everybody has a view about how they think the world should be run. But I had two small children and I lived in Broadfield, and our school that the children were going to didn't have a middle school then. Now the schools go right through from 4 until 11. It had no middle school, and we were expected from a new estate as it was then to walk our children to Tilgate, which is a good couple of miles from where we live. And the people from West Sussex County Council thought that was fine, and I didn't. So I started to campaign for a new school in Broadfield, and that's where my political activity began. Years. It was quite a long time. I did three terms. I was also the mayor, so that's a good thing to do, particularly as a woman, because you can get into organisations, women's organisations, and really shine a light on the work that they're doing. And those many years ago, and I very much admire the work of the Women's Resource Centre here, but then we had some new and interesting women's centres that were working then, and it was great to be able to highlight them and to work with them. So it's something that's been going on for women for a very long time, and being a mayor is very helpful to that. It's about using those parts of us, because if you're a woman and you've got children, I've got three sons and grandchildren now. And if you get yourself elected onto a local council, it's about learning how to use those parts of you to be influential. And hearing women's stories is one of the most influential way of getting people to listen. So if you had to walk two little children and a baby in a pushchair all the way to Tilgate from Broadfield, they sat up and listened. And it's a way of using our experience that's so useful to us as women. Much that we need to do, and there is so much more that we need to keep on. It almost breaks my heart when I think, oh my goodness, we were doing this 30 years ago, and we're still having to fight for women's rights. We're still having to fight to get more women on local councils because it's so unattractive, and I completely understand why. But if you could just keep going and support other women, the one thing I found most valuable, particularly in living in Crawley, is that there are so many women who are prepared to help each other. It's no good being a queen bee thinking you can do everything yourself. You have to do it together. You have to take each other on a journey. And that's such a wonderful thing about women in Crawley, that they're able to do that. I think I'm really passionate about equality. I'm very passionate about people having a fair chance. I'm very passionate about celebrating when people do extremely well, particularly women. I think it's so important for all of us to gather together and to really make the most of our community. We meet so many good people, and sometimes I feel, gosh, if they just had a bit more support at home, if they just had a bit more support outside, they could use their skills and be much more fulfilled. I mean, if you don't want to do it, that's absolutely fine. But I often find that women are keen to do things, and all they need is just a little bit of help from others. And so that's my passion that drives me on. Still, if I find a woman that's very keen to either get into Parliament or be able to and wants some help and advice, I always want to make sure that I'm there for them. I think probably some volunteering first, because that helps you to understand what your community is and how it's functioning. So getting into the many groups within Crawley is always a good way to learn. Learning how to speak in public is also very important, because there will come a time, if you're going to be a representative, that you're going to have to speak in front of someone. So it's really important that you learn to do that. But you can do that with someone very quietly, behind closed doors, and pick up those skills. It's not magic, it's just hard work, but it can be done, and most people can do it. Oh, I'm a big fan of Michelle Obama, mainly because she, I think, really encompasses the will of women around the world. She knows that given the right support, and given all of the things that we know that women need to prosper, then they can overcome. And it's her that's the one that I turn to very often for her quotes, of which there are many. I think it's really important for women, particularly mothers of sons, that they understand how much we have to work with them, so that they respect and understand women. Equality and diversity in our communities is so important. It's so easy to not challenge our children, because it's a very difficult job. But I think we do have a responsibility to make sure that they understand that they have a way in this world that treats women well and understands that they are equal to them, and that they will believe that throughout their lives, so that when they become fathers, they know that that has to be.